Hi everyone, it's Ranger Jones and welcome to a new video. Today I'm at Hämelhausen wind farm in Lower Saxony, halfway between Hanover and Bremen. And on the site, Enercon builds a prototype triplet for the first time using its new E160 EP5 E3 turbine. That's the first turbine with its new e-nacelle, and that's a major milestone in its turnaround program. So the first turbine is up. It was just completed this week, and I saw a reel on Enercon's Instagram account showing a time lapse of the blade installation. Wow, really huge. You can't really see the e-nacelle very well from the back, but I will move a little bit closer for you so you can have a better look at it from the side. The other two towers are over there, one behind the forest, and the other one right over there. The crane is still fully assembled, so they probably just finished it before Easter and left for the Easter holidays. There's also some existing turbines on the site. 5 Vestas V126, 3.3 megawatts, 137 meter hub height. There's 3, and there's 2 more. I'm so lucky today. The weather is amazing. It's super sunny. A little cold though. It's a little chilly with the wind, but it's so worth it. I was so excited to come here today, and I'm really stoked to explore the site. And I hope you guys are as well. All right, I'm gonna move a little closer now and check out the turbine from up close. I moved a little closer now, and from here you have a really gorgeous view on the turbine. Wow, I'm just amazed. It looks so different than anything else that we're used to seeing from Enercon. If somebody had told me a few years ago that Enercon would completely move away from its iconic X-shaped nacelle and replace it with a box-shaped nacelle, I probably wouldn't have believed it. The transition to the EP3 and EP5 platforms was already quite tremendous, but the transition to the e-nacelle is even bigger. Yeah, but competition on the market is really tough. It's all about reducing the cost of electricity and producing the most powerful yet cheap turbine. And the e-nacelle is the answer to becoming a more competitive player on the market again. Wow, really boxy. I saw some really funny comments online though, where people compared it to a mobile home that you could actually live in. I think you could actually live in there. It's quite large. And somebody asked, when can I move in? I actually like it. At first I was really skeptical because it does look just like a container, but it looks really elegant and simple. M plus S Wind is one of the shareholders of the wind farm. Yeah, but the e-nacelle comes with a lot of advantages. Production costs are cheaper, transport and logistics are easier, and the installation is also faster because the e-nacelles are already fully cabled and tested at the factory, and there is no installation of a separate e-module in the tower base needed anymore. So that in turn means that transmission losses from the tower to the e-module are being greatly reduced, and therefore the nominal power also increases from 5.5 to 5.56. Not much, but every additional home that can be powered with green electricity is great, of course. They also switch the cables from low to medium voltage, which also speeds up the commissioning process. I think, as with the EP3 and EP5 platform, it probably just takes some time to get used to it, and after a while, it will be pretty normal. Now I'm almost underneath the turbine. I can't get to the site itself because there's security patrolling literally everywhere, but you have a really great view of it from here. Wow, such a giant. The rotor diameter is really impressive. I think one single blade is 78 meters long. Really quite large. I mean, there are already bigger rotor diameters on the market, but it's still quite impressive. I think they didn't change anything about the hub or the rotor plates. They're identical to the EP5 E2. Just the nacelle is different. I already mentioned it. Hub height is 166 meters, and I think it will be available with hub heights of 99 up to 166 meters. The only thing that I'm really surprised about is that they used a hybrid tower instead of a modular steel tower, as for the other EP5 E2 turbines that I've seen in the past. I don't know. Maybe the hybrid tower is cheaper. Maybe it's faster to erect. I don't know. Maybe some of you guys know. But I will also go see a wind farm the next few days that I'm here with E160 turbines on an MST tower. That will be in a separate video then. I'm also quite curious what effect the war in Ukraine will have on material costs and turbine prices. From colleagues I heard the other day that due to the corona pandemic, turbine prices have significantly increased because of interrupted supply chains and so on. Almost up to €1 million or dollars even per turbine. So quite tremendous. And I don't think that's going to change anytime soon. I also read an article the other day about the wind fair in Bilbao, where CEOs of major wind turbine companies voiced their concerns about the market and admitted that they are selling turbines with great financial losses right now. So it's overdue for the German government to do something about that. Provide some support for the wind industry and don't let the wind industry just disappear from Germany as the solar industry did. Because that's not only a major loss of jobs, but even more, it's a loss of know-how, expertise, and great German manufacturing skills. As you can see, the crane is still fully assembled. They just installed the turbine and then left for the Easter break, probably. Also a great view on the Vestas turbines. Really nice. Really gorgeous. Also with the blue background. Really cool. Now I'm at one of the other construction sites. I already mentioned it. It's a prototype triplet. Really cool. Three prototypes at the same time. And from here, you have a really cool view on all the different components. So the tower is up. The bottom part, at least. So the concrete part. And then there will be three steel tower sections on top of that. I'm pretty sure it's the exact same tower that they use for the EP3 platform as well. So a Max Bögle tower. I'm just curious why they used a hybrid tower instead of an MST tower. I don't know. So over there are the rotor plates. You can't really see them that well. Much more impressive if you see them from above or if you stand right beside them. That's the rotor hub over there and the generator, which actually has a really small diameter. And then there it is, the e-nacelle. Wow. If I didn't know it was a nacelle, I would have thought it's just a container. Crazy. I wrote down the measurements. So it's 14.06 meters long, 4.99 meters wide, and 3.40 meters tall. So it's more than double the size of the nacelles of the EP5 E2 and the EP3 platforms. Really amazing. And then there's the three steel tower sections that will be lifted on top of the concrete tower. I think they're slightly longer because the tower is 166 meters and the towers for the EP3 platform are just 160 meters tall. And the third construction site is over there. And it looks like all the other components have arrived as well. Very nice. Okay, so now I'm behind the construction site. From here, you have a great view on the backside of the turbine. Also, a pretty good view on the crane, which is still fully assembled and on the ground. Pretty damn large. I'm pretty excited to see how long it takes them to erect the other two turbines. They installed the first one pretty quickly, I believe, and they installed the blades in just one day using the new blade gripper tool. So no hub rotation tool needed anymore, but the blade gripper can install the blades in all different kinds of angles. Enercon also posted a reel of the blade installation on their Instagram account. You should definitely have a look at it. It's really cool. So if the weather is favorable the next few weeks, it should go pretty fast. And maybe there are some other people in the area who will report about the construction process. From here, you have a great view of the e-nacelle from behind. It's just really wide and relatively flat. I think even the nacelle of the neighboring Vestas turbines are taller. Looks like people are still sleeping because the blinds of the mobile home are still down. Yeah, moving forward, all Enercon turbines will be based on the e-nacelle. The next turbines that will follow are the E138 EP3 E3. And the E115 EP3 E4, and all of them will have an increased nominal power. I'm just really hoping that Enercon comes up with a new, more powerful turbine soon, because other turbine manufacturers are a little bit ahead with more powerful turbines. There was some speculation about an E190. I don't know if that's just a rumor or if the rumor is actually true, but I guess we will find out pretty soon. All right, I think I'm gonna take off. I'm gonna make my way back to the train station. I'm really excited about your comments to hear what you think about the e-nacelle. Yeah, following are some drone shots now. I hope you like it, and maybe I'll see you in the next video. Happy Easter, everybody. Take care.